Okay, we're back. Oh boy. Sorry, I gotta eat my blueberry dinner. Those guys used to pretty much one-shot me. Still blocked. Alright. So probably the last character we'll be getting. I mean, for it's not a very long game, but yeah, like you have a pretty large amount of characters for a pretty short game.
Yeah!
Yeah, so the last character will probably be able to smash these rocks. Oh fuck, I'm gonna miss that. Yeah, this is the one, so that accessory is the one that, I believe lowers your defense, but increases your attack. So, glass cannon artifact, or glass cannon artifact.
Leave it to me.
back to town then. You know what? Let's do the quest on all the cities, actually. Let's start with... Castanet. Damn you and your chicken. It's too bad I can't, like, rotate the camera. Is that it? Okay. Thank you. shitty area. Oh shit, look at that. Clear. Warp to Celray. Oh man, that's awesome to be able to just go to your location. Yeah, so I think I remember there was a similar quest to this in Trails of Cold Steel, but they ask you to man, that's weak. But I mean, it's 30% burning, so still weak. Holy shit, why am I... fuck. Are you kidding me? Fuck. better be fucking worth it. That's actually whack. Down already. I thought it was gonna be a fucking easy quest. But no, like you fucking use a sword that damages you. Holy shit, dude. Yeah!
turn.
Using the sword. Misty Peak. How far west is it? How far west is it? Maybe it's here. Alright, I think. Okay, okay. Okay, okay, okay.
Leave it to me!
place to start harvesting here. That's one. Let's go. Fuck. Holy shit. I fucking hit that one. Alright, let's go back to Celerate. God damn. Holy shit, dude. That fucking sucks. That damage is like 72 per 72 per second? Or 72 per like 2-3 seconds, I think? Probably at that rate, but holy shit, dude. That's bad. Nuts. Says that. Is it still damaging? Curiosity. Oh boy, I'm sorry, but what's the status effect again? Holy shit, that's actually a pretty strong knife. That's a 2 plus 5. God damn. Okay, it's just, it's not too bad, it's just scary, it actually inflicts heavy. That's nice. Yeah, this actually, this might be her main weapon for now. The respawn is there. Okay, so Wind Edge sucks. Flame Sword is actually pretty interesting. We're adding some flame damage to that. It's a little weak. Yeah, no, I don't think it's good enough. Like, yeah, I'll probably just focus on the Spider's Edge. Because the Spider's Edge is a hell of a lot more stronger than... Let's see, what does... Yeah, Feather Knife is 92 Spider... Yeah. Statuses. Not for the hell of it. Let's give it one more. And a little frost. Alright, it should be fine. actually. Let's see the movement. Alright, so let's see if the solar side quests are done.
Right. My turn. Leave it to me. Have one of those. Wow. Look who's talking, man. You know what? I prefer to think I'm a man of culture. Oh wow, filthy degenerate. It's culture, bruh. It's culture. How are you liking your DSL, man? Did you go with did you go with Dito? Oh, sorry, fiber. How are you liking your fiber, sir? I'm sorry, when you say fiber, it's gigabit internet, man. Is fiber different from gigabit? I thought they're pretty much the same speed. Oh, okay. Cause yeah, from what I understand, like fiber is usually like at least a gigabit. Okay. It feels like you're getting ripped off, honestly, when you tell me that, oh, that's fiber, it's 40 up and down. Like, are you really? Okay, so it's not, it's fiber off. Okay. But is it the, who's the provider? Dito? Did you go with Dito? Hey man, you wanna be in Uncle Xi's pocket? I mean, technically, with all the stuff that we've been enrolling through, like, all of it is, like, technically Chinese-made or made in China, like, I think they already know, man. Also, I'd like to think that we're not important enough. Like, we're not high profile to be, like, target of information scams. I mean, they'll target. And? It's not like, what are they gonna do with that information? Hold on. I have to allow it. There you go. I don't know. We gotta kill the bear, bro. The bear must die. So are they easing up the restrictions over there? Like, well, it's hard to define, like, if they say, like, they're easing up, it's hard to define what it means. Hmm. Well, technically, you just warp here. I mean, technically, they're all, like, everyone's a conservative over there. Technically. No, I mean, almost everyone. Like, majority, since majority of Filipinos is technically conservative. You're centrist, but you're left-leaning. A lot of your principles is technically, like, liberal. So I wouldn't call you, like, outright... Yeah. I wouldn't call you outright, like, centrist. You're probably more left. Center-left or something like that? But yeah. Actually, here's the thing, like, I kind of notice, talking with my older brother, there seems to be a lot of, I kind of notice that a lot of our generation actually is, like, we just based on the social media anyway, I've only known a few that are pro-administration. A lot of our batchmates seems to, like, either it's split over the middle or probably leaning more against the administration. Which is impressive because, like, my elder brother's batch is, pretty much blind supporters and shit, dude. Based on what he's telling me. Yeah, dude, like, our batch seems, I'd say the divide would be 60-40. 60 against the admin, 40 pro. Would that be a more fair estimate? Because there seems to be a lot more, like, either center or, like, leaning against the administration and, like, outright pointing out the dumb bullshit that they do. I think... Yeah, it is. But originally, I think when he got elected, I'd say the divide is closer to, I'd say... Yeah, I'd say, to be generous, 55-45. That'd be fair. There's still more. It's not a lot. Difference, like probably like margin of 5% margin of error, but yeah, 55-45, 55 against the admin. No, in the beginning. It's probably around 55-45. But then as the fuck-ups continue to pile on, people are like, yeah, so. Boom, shortcut.
Leave it to me.
Now it's 60-40. Yeah, that's what I kind of thought. Like, the batch 4 years higher than us is pretty hard. A lot of them are, based on my brother's statements, it seems like 7:30. Yeah, Yeah, I think the batch 99, because I think we're batch 2003, so batch 99, there's a lot more, I'd say, based on Brother's statements, like, it's either 65 or 70. 65 to 70 versus 30 who are against. 35, 30 who are against. So I don't know. Maybe it's a generation thing, but yeah. I don't know. It's a weird. You'd expect that, you know, people from my. No, but they're not even old. Like, they're not that old. They're like 4 years above us. We're Gen Ys, though, right? Well, technically, all of our generation, like 2003 batch, they're all like, we're all millennials, dude. Technically, we're all millennials. And we're, you know, we're poo-pooing avocado toast and shit. Yeah, technically, yes, we are the first gen millennials. And we're poo-pooing avocado toast. And we're apparently destroying a lot of the restaurant industry. I'm just laughing, dude. We're always getting blamed for, like, killing, like, chain restaurants and shit. Are you still on keto? Are you back in keto? Okay. Oh man, that feels hard. Like, right now I'm like, I'm just on maintenance now. My maintenance is, with my current activity, my maintenance is around 3,000 calories. Keto friendly? Okay. So you're not allowed to have like what veggies are you allowed? Like spinach, probably. Okay. Oh shit, the fruits thing is hard. The fruit things are hard. Fucking right now I'm hooked on frozen blueberries. So it's intermittent fasting plus keto. Okay. I'm surprised you actually went with keto right away. I'd assume you just go with, like, straight up the easier way of calorie counting, because it's easier to keep track of a number. Plus it's less expensive. Not to mention. Especially in the Philippines? It's not gonna be cheap. I wouldn't think that keto is gonna be cheap in the Philippines. Especially with all the... No, it's not. Like, especially with the stuff there that's going on, I think there's a problem with the meat stocks there. Meat stocks. How's the situation there, by the way, with the when it comes to the meat market? It's still really bad. Like how much is the leanest cut of beef? Or how much is it per pound or per kilo? Okay. Are they still doing the stupid shit of like adding more taxes to import or lessening the taxes of import? Cut of pork. Okay. Good. That's actually good. What cut? What cut of beef is that? Because, yeah, I mean, you can say 400-ish per kilo. I mean, you say not bad, but depends on the cut. If it's like the super, like, what was that? I think it's a round? Chuck round? So, like, probably chucks. A little pricey though. Is it lean or fatty? Missouri cut. Is the cut lean or fatty? Or is it like the one for beefsteak? Okay, so yeah, that's not, yeah. 400 per kilo, so what, $8? $8 per kilo? I have to do my So it's $8 for 2 pounds. Holy shit, that's expensive, dude. Cause for a lean cut, that's pricey. Cause so the chuck I buy, that's around 3 to 4 pounds. It's actually less than $5. That's beef chuck, the chuck steak. But yeah, that's around the beef. Beef chucks are pretty lean. But yeah, that's pretty pricey, dude. 400 per kilo. Holy shit. And it's, you don't even know what cut it is, because it's like random, you know, random bullshit cuts. So they could have given you, they could have given you like the I think it's called the top round. Yeah, there you go. Look up this one. That is one of the I've actually tried it. No, but look, I think from what I remember, that particular cut is around $5 for 8 ounces. Or not $5, like $2 for 8 ounces. Or yeah, around $2 per, I think it was, I can't remember if it's like a pound at least, but it's like $2 for the pack, which is around probably 11 or like probably a pound, 11 ounces or a pound. And that cut is super cheap because it's like really lean, like insanely lean. It's like cardboard. I tried grilling it and I added, I saw that it was like super lean. I added like salt, pepper, and it still tasted like cardboard. No, you don't get it. Even if you use herb butter on that particular steak, there's no like taste on it. Like, it's bad, dude. Like, I think one of the worst. It's one of the worst cut I've ever tasted. It's that bad. I don't know how to cook that. I don't think you can just grill that. Ribeye is pretty high in calories. That's why I'm trying to avoid it. If I want steak, I'd go for chuck. I believe chuck is around 200 calories per 4 ounces. And it tastes pretty good grilled, actually. Chuck, make it, cook it to medium rare. Or medium well. Yeah, chuck steak is pretty good. It's cheap. It's a cheap cut too. It's not that expensive. Because like for a couple of pounds of chuck, it's around $6 or $7, depending on the store, depending on the promo. Again, the chuck steak is it's a pretty good balance of like lean. Okay, that makes sense. But still, like, you know, I thought the only reason I got that cut was because I was in a budget, and you know, I was still in my cutting period on that point. So, oh, it's like... Oh, yeah. Because, like, fucking... Beef is expensive, bruh. Actually, I think I just added rice. I added carbs after I lost the initial 100 pounds. No, man, you gotta, that's the thing, you gotta introduce it, No, but you gotta introduce it. That's the thing, like... So you're ending your keto in July? Gonna like slowly introduce carbs back. I actually like the way they're doing it. So, it depends on the enemy, like this, she's a piercing attack. So there's some enemies, like this one is the main character is slashing, and then you have a striking character. So it's, the persona. Persona 3 method of, like, damage type. That's why, like, at least you have to have one or, One of each. Yeah. P3 damage type. But the good thing about this is, like, you can, as long as you have money in the game, you can, like, unlimitedly modify your weapon. So, like, for example, my main character has pretty good, can inflict freeze, fire, paralysis, poison, drain. I forgot what the other one is. Damage types. So I put freeze on all of the weapon types, on all their weapons, just so, like, they can stop the enemy on their tracks. And then Karna's weapon can actually inflict additional heavy damage, so it, like, slows their movement. Holy shit. Dude, if you wanna get into the East franchise, I'd say start with Lacrimosa of Dana. Oof. Fuck. That seems to be progress. I think it's out on PC. Lacrimosa of Dana has a more refined combat. Like, Lacrimosa of Dana is around 2016, 2017. This one is 2012. So it's pretty old. What, 8 years or 9 years old now? So yeah, they're like, it's a. So yeah, you can see how dated it is, but yeah, with there's Dogi. Yeah, that one. You say. Because the older ones, it's a little hard to get into. Like, it took me a while to actually get used to this one. Plus, that one actually has better BGM. Yeah, the main problem I'm seeing with this is you can see how dated it is with the music. Progress. God damn it. Uh. That's how I actually got into a Yeast franchise. Was a Lacrimosa of Dana. The gameplay is similar to this, but the graphic quality is a lot better. It's a lot cleaner with the designs. Oh shit. Well, I guess that's the problem. It's a dead end, so. Oh, okay. So, Lacrimosa of Dana is actually interesting because. Yeah, you're like survive. Yeah, like you're trying to survive in an island, pretty much.
Who retells stories of the ancient past. Welcome, Adol. I know you've had a...
I was expecting a tough warrior or something. Not a kid. Is he really up to the job? Where are you looking?
Is it bad? Or you're having issues running it? Oh shit. Including the new DLC that's coming out? Isn't there a new one? The Asian, like the one Asian inspired? Okay, so that's actually a sequel. Alright. Okay. I thought it was a DLC for some reason. Okay. Oh man, I can't warp. Alright, we'll wrap it up here. I'm gonna go to sleep, man. It's already 11:50, so. Got pretty far though. 67%. Not bad.
It's almost done, man. 67% of the map. So, yeah, dude. I'm sleepy. Plus, I've been working. Plus, I'm frustrated. Okay, so, hold on. Alright, hold on. Let me save first. So, what was that? So let's switch. Alright. Oh god. So this is the cables I actually got. So you saw I sent you the picture, right? The picture doesn't match the cables. Like, look how thin this is. Exactly. Look how thin this damn thing is. And then I think you saw the pic, right? Like, it feels like a regular sized what do you call this? It looks like a regular sized cable, or like a regular size cable extension, you know, the one that Corsair actually sells. And yeah, no, dude, it's bad. I tried installing it earlier, and it says it fits an HX series. It's not even, the sad part is, it's not even from Wish. It's from Amazon. So, so I'm returning it tomorrow. I'll send it back tomorrow. So, should be fine, I think. Right. Yeah, well, the known brands is $100 for four cables. So, I don't know, man. The one I think I ordered from before was Asia Horse. So Asia Horse is kind of familiar, but they only have extensions. They don't have the actual cables, because what I'm trying to do is, the ones I have right now, I think is Asia Horse, if I remember correctly. But they're just extensions. So there's still a shitloads of cables in the back of my PC. Oof. Ouch, bruh. Misogyny. Uh-oh. Oh, bruh. No, hell no. Oh boy. All right, I gotta get to sleep. I have to start. I have to go running tomorrow morning early. All right. Have a good night.